لكن بس كيف وصلت بقصة نجيكي هوت نجلو هلوغت أذا كي for a long time at last day فيك أصيب سنلي سكي جلوت and the magic began to work كيف بس توي توي بير coming to life تادي كيف كيف أشيك wake up he said the magic he is glowing the magic is working Kiba sat up and rubbed his eyes he looked at his toys come on Kiba said Kasma hurry up it is time for a magic adventure the toys ran to the little house hurry up Kiba called Teddy be quick or it will be too late Kiba could feel the magic working it pulled him inside the magic house. The magic whisked Kiba round and round. Oh help, called Kiba, I feel different. This is a different sort of magic. The magic took them to an airport. It was a very busy airport. Kasma was excited. Maybe we can catch a plane, he said. Maybe we can have an exciting adventure. There were bears everywhere. They were going to Switzerland. They were going to the teddy bears picnic. The teddy, they have one every year. Maybe we can go to said Bamberry. He was not so sure. How can we eat the basket? Of course, we can go, said Teddy. This is a magic adventure. Kiba and his friends went on the aeroplane to Switzerland. They flew over lakes and mountains. What a beautiful place for a picnic, said Kiba. When the plane landed, everyone got off. There were lots and lots of bears. Kiba had never been seen so many. They had come from all over the world. It is going to be a big picnic, said Kiba. There was a bus at the airport. It was going to the teddy bear's picnic. Come on, said Kasimir. If we run, we can catch this bus. Kiba liked Switzerland. It is beautiful here, said Kiba. It was fun on top of the bus. The bears waved at Bears waved at everyone and everyone waved back. At last, the bus arrived. Everyone got off. I've never seen so many bears, said Kiba. We'd better stay together in case we get lost. Kiba and his friends found a good place to sit. Suddenly, everyone shouted and cheered. A famous bear had come on to the stage. He waved at the crowd. Welcome to the Teddy Bear's picnic, he said. I know him, said Kiba. He's a very famous bear. Indeed. I've read all his stories, all his books. Another famous bear came on the stage. To the stage, he began to tell jokes and sing funny songs. Everyone laughed and cheered. I know that famous bear too, said Kiba. I've seen him on TV. a famous pop group came to the stage. They played well, the best at the picnic. This is the best picnic I've ever been to, said Kiba. Kiba had an autograph book. He wanted some of the famous guests to sign their names. I can show them to Buff and Chip and said Kiba. Then they sail. Now I've had a magic adventure. They went to find the famous bears, but there was trouble. Some nasty bears were pushing the famous bears into a car. This a kidnap, said Bunbury. We must do something. The car sped away. Casimir saw a van. Come on, he shouted, get in. We can follow the kidnappers in this van. Casimir drove the van as fast as he could. The car went even faster. It drove up a mountain. Faster, faster, called Bunbury. Don't lose them. Lose them, called Teddy. The car drove through some big gates and stopped in front of a house. The famous bears were pushed inside. It looks dangerous, said Kiba, but we must rescue them. I have a plan. Kiba and Casimir went to the house. Kiba rang a bell. Some nasty bears came to the door. Free honey, called Kiba. Free honey for every bear. The nasty bears were greedy and they couldn't rest the honey. Where is the honey? They didn't see that what Teddy and Bunbury were doing. Teddy went to the car and took out the keys. Bunbury went to the back of the house and looked through a window. He saw the famous bears. They were tied up. Bunbury set the famous bears free. Then they all climbed out of the window. Come on, said Teddy. Follow me and don't make a sound. The famous bears crept into the honey van. The nasty bears didn't see them because they were too busy eating the honey. One of the nasty bears saw that the famous bears were escaping there in the one honey van. He shouted, go after it. Casimir drove the honey ran as fast as he could. The nasty bears ran after the van, but they got stuck in the honey. Hooray, shouted Kiba. The famous bears were pleased with Kiba and his friends. You were very clever, they said. Thanks to you, the teddy bear picnic can go on. The magic key began to glow. It was time for Kiba's adventure to end. I can't wait to tell Beth and Chip about it, he said. The magic key glowed. Last night, said Kiba, I had a magic adventure. We don't believe you, said Beth. No, it was just a dream, said Chip. The end.